Greetings, my fellow giant gun enthusiasts, and welcome to another Warhammer 40k lore video about the divisions of the Adeptus Mechanicus. In today's episode, I wanted to talk to you about the Centurio Ordinatus, aka the biggest deployable surface weapons the Imperium can bring to bear, alongside the mighty Titans, of course. Since I considered there's a bit too much lore about these for a single episode, I decided to make two parts. Today I will talk to you about what Ordinatii are, some of their history, and what kinds of weapons they use. And next time I will introduce the various types of these city block-sized weapon platforms. I am your host, the Grimdark Narrator, and without further ado, let us proceed, shall we? The Centurio Ordinatus is an ancient sub-branch of the Divisio Militaris, able to trace their history back to the Age of Strife before the birth of the Imperium, when Mars was an independent human empire ruled by the tech priests of the cult Mechanicum. The Centurio Ordinatus is a highly specialized force, created to deal with siege works or the demands of a specific battle. The immense war engines of the Ordinatus were created by the individual forge worlds to fulfill very particular roles. The Ordinatus classification held the most powerful and arcane mobile weapons platforms in the Mechanicum's arsenal. They were city burners and fortress breakers without compare, and whether armed with magma beam lances, matter cyclone, or rad conflagrators, each was mounted on huge tracked reactor units for mobility and heavily shielded from attack, allowing them to traverse and survive on the most hellish battlefield. Each one was a work of deadly artifice and ancient power. Much like the Titans, whose power they actually outstripped, the Ordinatus varied in scale and potency. From the truly colossal, unique and unreplicable relics of the Dark Age of Technology, the Ordinatus Primaris, such as the Mars and Endymion, whose power was legendary, to the lesser but still gargantuan and deadly Ordinatus Minoris subclasses. The Minoris were, at the height of the Great Crusade, within the reach of only the most potent forge worlds to construct, and even then in very limited number. During the Horus Heresy, when the galaxy was torn apart by civil war, both loyalist and traitor forces of the Centurio Ordinatus unleashed all manner of forbidden and experimental weapons upon each other. Such were the gifts that the renegade forge world of Zana II offered. No less than three such terrifying weapons of the Ordinatus Ulator pattern, fully battle-ready and armed with devastating sonic disruptor weapons. These were Titan killers, each one powerful enough to turn the tide of battle with a single strike, and in potency far beyond the super-heavy tank like the Bane Blade, and dwarfing the firepower of even the mighty Diamatine siege guns that had fallen into the grasp of the Iron Warriors earlier in the Horus Heresy. During the Horus Heresy, Mars itself, homeworld of the Mechanicum, was riven by civil war. This deadly internecine conflict erupted on Mars between the loyalist factions of the Mechanicum and the traitors of the Dark Mechanicum during the open days of the Heresy, and was known as the Schism of Mars. The traitor Mechanicum armies, commanded by Magos Solomon Abaddon, not to be confused with Ezekiel Abaddon, later known as the Despoiler, turned against the Emperor and attempted to overthrow those Mechanicum elements loyal to the Emperor. From his mountain fortress of Jericho, the Magos sent forth his rebel forces to attack their forge factories and installations. Inevitably, the Imperium retaliated and sent an Imperial expeditionary fleet commanded by the Imperial Fist's first captain Sigismund, four companies of Imperial Fists, and a large force of the Imperial Army, in order to annihilate Magos Abaddon's treacherous minions and bring Imperial justice. This proved impossible, though, since the fortress of Jericho was protected by an ancient alien device discovered during the Great Crusade. The vortex field generator, as it was called, rendered any attack from orbit impossible. Any ship which got too close was torn apart or displaced into the warp. Eventually, an Imperial army fought its way to the foothills of the mountains, a few kilometers away from Jericho, where it discovered that the vortex field did not cover the planet's surface. Castellum Jericho, as the citadel was known, boasted walls half a mile thick, which soared into the clouds. The central bastion was constructed from the hardest metal alloy known to man, and could withstand any amount of pounding by the Imperium's siege engines. Another solution was needed, and the Loyalist Mechanicum provided the answer. The Ordinatus Mars utilized unique technology to produce a sound wave which resonated across the battlefield. When this sonic wall hit Castellum Jericho, the walls crumbled to dust as they shook themselves apart. The infamous Tower of Steel bent and crumpled like foil, filling the air with tortured shrieks of twisting metal. Thousands of troops poured into the breach, and Solomon Abaddon was summarily executed for his treason. Following the end of the Horus Heresy, many of these Leviathan siege engines were lost or forgotten. Some remained hidden, deep underground or in remote locations, while others remained hidden in secret armories lost to the ages. Often the rediscovery of such potent engines of destruction results in conflict, as opposing factions vie for control of these powerful living icons of the machine god. Those few examples of Ordinatus weapons that still exist are deployed only sparingly, and many of them date back to the Great Crusade and have been maintained meticulously for thousands of years. These huge engines of destruction are not attached to any specific Titan Legion or Skitari army. Indeed, they fall under the direct control of the Centurio Ordinatus. It is this organization that decides if these highly specialized machines are to be made available to the Imperial military, since many of them are ancient indeed and require huge amounts of preparation and maintenance to ready them for war. Other Ordinatus have weapons and capabilities which see more general use, and demand for them is high. Only in the most important battles or campaigns are the Ordinatus sent to war, and even then, only for pre-specified operations. Among the enemies of the Imperium, the names of the Ordinatus are spoken with reverent fear, their devastating capability displayed on thousands of battlefields across Imperial history. The cult Mechanicus reveres the Ordinatus as sacred avatars of the machine god. Creations of such cunning and power, they can never be improved or made outdated. Thus, they have been carefully maintained, and when sent to war, they are inscribed with sacred runes, anointed with the most precious oils and unguents, and blessed by the Lord of the Centurio Ordinatus. Their crews are the most highly trained of the Skitari, warriors who fight with zealous fanaticism to defend these holy weapons. The Ordinatii are renowned for their relentless advance towards the enemy, trailing havoc and destruction in their wake. Ordinatii are powered by immense plasma generators, which drive the tracks and energize the weapon systems. These are very volatile, and if the Ordinatus is destroyed, they will explode spectacularly in a massive ball of roiling plasma. Ordinatii are protected by a massive energy shield known as a dispersion field. Projectiles and energy bolts deflect harmlessly away from this crackling dome of power, leaving the Ordinatus unscathed. Unfortunately, the dispersion field requires tremendous amounts of power, and will eventually overload its generators. The following weapons are commonly employed by different Ordinatii. The Hellfire Missile. Hellfire is a common term for a potent acidic or viral compound developed by the Adeptus Mechanicus. It burns through armor and sears flesh, usually leaving the few who survive hideously scarred and crippled. It is a matter of opinion whether or not it is better to die from a hellfire attack or to survive. Ordinatus Golgotha carries 6 Hellfire missiles and can only fire 1 or 2 per hour. A Hellfire missile has multiple warheads, allowing it to completely devastate a wide area. In addition, the extensive scanning equipment aboard Ordinatus Golgotha allows it to fire with unerring accuracy. The Hellfire missiles can be fired at any point on the battlefield, even at targets that are out of line of sight, with no chance of scattering. Unlike normal indirect barrages, there is no need for friendly troops to spot for the accurate launch of a Hellfire missile. Enemy units attacked by this horrendous weapon may be panicked by the agonized screams of their comrades as their flesh burns away and their bones melt. Nova cannons. The Nova cannon is similar to a plasma annihilator of an Imperator-class Titan. However, rather than releasing a burst of raw plasma, the Nova cannon can focus and control the potent energies with greater precision. This allows the crew to siphon small amounts of plasma into the discharge chamber, producing a rapid burst of fire. Alternatively, the crew can flood the chamber with all the remaining plasma and send out an earth-shattering blast of energy. In addition, the immense energy released by a massive burst produces a beam of plasma which covers a wide area. Bellicose Pattern Volcano Cannon. An ancient pattern of weapon whose destructive power is comparable to many shipboard cannon and planetary defense lasers. Few mobile weapon platforms are capable of mounting the Bellicose, simply due to its savage power requirements, as well as the danger of the thermal and radiation overspill of its firing. Only the Ordinatus Minoris and the most powerful battle titans, such as the Warlord, are ordained to bear such a weapon by the Mechanicum. And before their power, the strongest fortress walls may be reduced to glowing embers, and the most resilient armor to molten slag and vapor. The Sonic Disruptor. A sonic disruptor utilizes unique technology that produces sound waves which resonate across the battlefield. Crumbling buildings, shattering bones, bursting organs, and causing electronic equipment to explode as the wall of sonic energy passes the enemy forces. The sonic disruptor scales repeatedly up and down these frequencies, causing a blast of sonic energy that rolls forward like a force wave from a massive conventional explosion. Hiding in cover is of little use, since woods and rubble are just blown apart, and walls simply amplify the sonic wave if they are not shattered. Even the weighty armor of a Titan, or the reinforced buttresses of a stronghold, provide little protection against the wrath of a sonic disruptor, most of which were first deployed by the Ordinatus Mars. Targets protected by energy fields, such as void shields, will lose one shield to the sonic wave before it passes. And this, my friends, has been what I wanted to tell you about the Centurio Ordinatus and their gigantic weapon platforms. Would you like to have one of these in your army? Or would you rather stick to horde tactics and massed armored assaults? Let me know in the comments below. As usual, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to click the like button and maybe subscribe if you want to see more videos in the future. I thank you very much for watching and wish you a peaceful day. The Emperor protects.